Hello everyone. In our last topic, we discussed about the first method for valuation of goodwill. That is a simple average profit method. Okay, that is also known as average profit method. In that, we can find out average profit by dividing the total profit of number of year. Okay, here we move on to our next method. That is a method number two. That method is known as method 2, that is a weighted average profit method. Okay, this word is not new for you. That is a weighted average. You already studied in your 11th commerce. If you remember, that is weighted average. It is also known as weighted mean. That is a x bar w that equals to sigma xi wi upon sigma wi. Okay, here wi is stand for weight. Whenever in a company, the profit of the company will be continuously increasing since last few years. At that time, we cannot find the average profit, that is simple average profit, but we can or we has to find a weighted average profit. In here, in our 12th commerce, okay, they already specified you has to do it average profit or weighted average profit. But in reality, if there is a continuous increasing in our profit, then we has to calculate our goodwill on the basis of weighted average profit method. Here they already specified to you. Okay, here W is stand for weight. Weight is given, but if the weight is not given, then he has to take 1, 2, 3, 4 that already you've taken in your 11th commerce. Okay, so here if we has to find out the weighted average profit, so the formula for weighted average profit equals to total weighted profit upon total weight. Okay, in average profit method, we take only total profit and divide it by number of year. Here we has to take total weight. Okay, ye yaad rakhna hai that we has to remember. Okay, we has to consider here total weight, not a number of years. Then the second step for finding out the value of goodwill, that equals to weighted average profit into number of year purchases. Okay, so basically there are only two changes in second method. In first method, we has to consider here number of year. Instead of that, we has to consider total weight. And secondly, for calculation of goodwill, at that method we can calculate only average profit, but here we has to calculate on the basis of weighted average profit. Okay, so there are only two steps for calculation of goodwill under weighted average method. First, we has to find out the average profit, and second, that we has to find out the value of goodwill. Okay, let's move on to example. That is illustration number 4. Compute the value of goodwill by 3 years of purchase. Clearly mentioned, 3 years of purchase of weighted average. Dekho, clearly mentioned weighted average of how many years? 5 years. Okay, whenever we are doing a weighted average method, the first precondition that we has to check in each and every example is that our data is always in chronological order. Like the year 12, 13, 13, 14, 14, 15, 15, 16, 16, 17. So it is already given in chronological order, so we did not has to arrange. But if it is not given, then we has to arrange in chronological order for calculation of weighted average profit method. Okay, the year is given, the profit is given, but weight is not given. So we has to take a weight. Okay, we can consider for 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, then we has to find the total weight. That is 5 plus 4, 9, 9 plus 1, 10, 10 plus 2, 12, 12 and 3, 15. So total weight equals to 15. Then has to calculate a weighted profit. How we can get? Demo. Okay, see here, there is a two words. First is a weight and second is a profit. So weight and profit, these two are multiplied. That we get a weighted profit. Okay, that is 80,000 into 1. That comes to 80,000. 120,000 into 2 comes to 240,000. 140,000 into 3 comes to 420,000. 160 into 4, that comes to 640,000. And 170,000 into 5 comes to 850,000. Okay, and here we have to consider the total, that is known as total weighted profit. Okay, that is 80 plus 20, that is 1 lakh, 2 lakh 30,000, 230 and 20, that is 22 lakh 30,000. Okay, 22 lakh 30,000 is our total weighted profit. Total weight is 15. So first of all, we have to find a weighted average profit. How we can get? That the simple formula, total weighted profit divided by total weight. Okay, our total weighted profit will be 22 lakh 30,000 and the total weight is 15. Okay, if we divide that thing, then our answer is 1,48,666.666. Okay, that is in decimal. If we want to consider this into a perfect figure, then 1,48,667. Both are valid in your examination. Okay, secondly, we have to find out the goodwill. Goodwill equals to weighted average profit into number of year purchases. Okay, so weighted average profit will be 1,48,667 into how many number of year purchases given? 3 years of purchase. So here we have to consider a 3. Okay, then we have to find out, multiply that amount, that will be a 4,46,001. Okay, if you consider this decimal, then your answer is 1,48,666.666 into 3 karenge, then we can get 4,46,000. That is a perfect figure. Okay, if we consider perfect figure, then here the difference of only 1 rupees, that doesn't matter. Okay, basically for calculation of weighted average method, we have to consider the two things. First, the data is always in chronological order. Second, we have to put a weight if it is not given. In majority cases, they cannot give a weight to you in your examples. So we have to consider a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If there is a 5 year, then we have to consider weight 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If there is only 3 year, then we have to put 1, 2, 3 only. Okay, if there is a 4 year, then we have to put 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, that is to multiply the weight with the profit, then we get a weighted profit. Okay, weighted profit will be divided by total weight. Then we can get a weighted average profit. And the last simple, that is weighted average profit multiplied by number of year purchases. Okay, so this is the second method and easy method. Okay, today you have to do a illustration number 3. Okay, in your illustration 3, that is only and only calculation related to a weighted average profit. Okay, in illustration 3, they cannot ask you to calculate a goodwill. So keep in mind, if they told to you, you have to calculate a goodwill, then we can calculate a goodwill. If they don't specify for calculation of goodwill, then we have to just calculate a weighted average profit. They clearly mentioned in your illustration number 3. That is your homework. And from exercise, you have to do a 2 example. That is, I think so in your last session, question number 4 and question number 5 will be there. So here, the question number 7 and question number 4. 4, 5, okay, 6 and 7. So, 3 questions are in the homework, that illustration number 3, and from exercise question number 6 and question number 7. Okay.